What's going on, world? It's your man, Pat Caesar, Caesar LLC, More Mechanic and Roadside Services, and I'm going to give you a tip, actually a couple tips. Let's do five things you're going to need for your roadside assistance business to be moving. We're just going to throw some stuff on the ground. Let's start with our number one thing. You are going to need a jack. Now, the bigger, the better, but it depends on how you want to go about this, right? And I'm going to tell you why. You see, you may not want to be pulling the jack in and out of your truck or car or whatever you're working out of. The bigger the jack, the heavier it's going to be. You have to keep it in consideration. I preferably like a steel jack over aluminum. Aluminum significantly lighter, but I've broke way too many of them. And the last thing you need is something to break while it's under pressure. It could be catastrophic. But the first thing you're going to need is a good jack. Second thing you're gonna need is a good lockout kit. Now, I had to piece this thing together because I done had it forever. I've actually even heat shrinked this right here because I was getting in the semi one time, and it actually take off this plastic piece, but let's talk about this just for real quick. You do not want to use a cheap lockout kit. The ones that you get off of eBay, I'm gonna be completely 1,000 with you. I've tried them. I've tried multiple ones. They are trash. You want something of quality, because the last thing you want to do is be trying to get into somebody's car and your equipment breaks. I am telling you, I have learned from experience. Go with the best that you can get. I don't actually have any links right now, but when I get some links, I'll put them down below to what I feel from a few years of experience have been the best for me, the cheap versus the good stuff. Number three on the list is a good jump box. Now, I'm not plugging any of these people in, but this is equivalent to a JNC 660. This has been a very, very good tool for me. This has probably made me about the most money out of all of my other tools, only because I have personally needed a jump box for myself, and it's worked. Now, I cannot speak on every jump box, but I can tell you that I've used the Harbor Freight joints before, and they've been probably the worst. Not knocking Harbor Freight, because they do have some quality products at times, like that jack, for instance, I showed in the clip number one. That's from Harbor Freight. Electronic stuff have not had the very best of luck. And something like that, you want to go high quality, because I have jumped off semi trucks with this thing. Now, I struggled a little bit, let me be completely honest about that, but one or two of those together and you can jump pretty much anything. Plus, if you do go with like a JNC, they have a higher quality. I believe it's a 770, or I think they have 770 and a 1260. Don't quote me on those numbers, but they have higher calibers, and they last for years. They hold a charge, and I'm not trying to plug them in. I'm just saying, if you get something like that, get something that's small, that's light, that's portable, but also packs a huge punch, because the bigger, the better. You just got more variety of what you can do. Now, this was not in a particular order, but there's nothing that you could do with this without these. A breaker bar and sockets, and I'm putting both of these into a category. There again, you know, you can go as fancy with this as you want to, or you can go as low budget with this as you want to. The reason why I say that is because I particularly use an impact. Like, I hate using a breaker bar besides just breaking the bolts loose. And even at that, the impact, the higher quality you get, the more stuff you could break loose. They have 1-inch impacts now. They got 3/8, they got 1/2 inch, whatever you want. And it depends on how tight the bolts are, to be honest with you. So I've had all of them besides the 1-inch one. For like electric, for instance, but I mean, it's all up to you. The more money you want to spend on it, the more money you spend, typically the more efficient you'll be. So just keep that in mind as far as how efficient you actually want to be with what you're doing. It is 30 degrees outside where I'm at right now. You might not be able to tell, but just to throw another one in there, gloves. You definitely don't want to go anywhere without gloves, not only for you to protect your hands, but also for warmth. I mean, it's great. Just make sure whenever you are getting in and out of customers' cars, you leave the gloves where they're at, you get inside of the vehicle. When you're outside of the vehicle, put the gloves back on. Nobody wants to deal with no, you know, greasy hand type of person. I mean, my wife don't, but that's just my wife. I don't know about yours. Not to say there's no ladies in the industry, so let's get that clear. I'm just saying, most people don't like to deal with somebody who's dirty, as much as you can control it. Again, you can go as fancy with this as you want to, or as low budget as you want to, but lights are important. You can go as fancy or it's not so fancy as you want. This light in particular, this thing lights up the world, is so great, and it's Walmart brand, to be honest with you. It works. They don't actually sell this particular one no more, but this is also a strobe. So you on the side of the road, man, you're doing roadside assistance. Your lifeline is visibility. It is daytime and you can clearly see this. It's daytime and you can clearly see this. You want to be seen.
Why is this super important? Because when you're on the side of the road, people are not necessarily paying attention. They you know, you kind of get a tunnel vision. You know where you're going. The road seems the same as it always is, and most people don't think, you know, to pay attention. I'm not saying everybody, but accidents happen every day. You know, there's, I think it was like reported from AAA, like 35 million people like on the road at one given time in North America, especially through the holidays. People got places to go, people to see, and you know, they're not always right here. You know what I mean? So you got to be careful. As visible as you can make it sound, because somebody on their phone texting and driving, I mean, it takes a second to lose your life. It's super precious. So you want to be able to protect yourself as much as possible.
I can go down a whole list of things that you're going to need. And I mean, if you want to go into more detail about that, we can talk about it. Visit me at CesarAuto.com. You can hit me up. See that? Fast Tow Pro, Cesar Auto, IG, TikTok. Let's talk about it. I'm here to make sure that I help people stay safely on the road, get that bag, and go back home to their family safely at night, because that's what I'm trying to do out here. So I appreciate y'all tapping in, man. Y'all see where the information is at. Like, share, and subscribe. Catch y'all on the next one. Till then, be pro mundo beneficio, siempre.